There is a great new feature in Copilot for Excel. As soon as you open any Excel file, it looks at the data. And if it finds any problems, it's going to tell you that. A message comes on top. Click on it. It's going to open a pane on the right side. So it is telling me there are four problems. Let's go one by one. It's saying table 1 may have redundant extra spaces. The moment I highlight or just hover, it tells me where they are. And notice this is across columns. Now, if I'm not sure if the data is large, of course, I can scroll and look at each instance. And the best part is one click and it's done. Look at the spelling, inconsistent text. It knows the actual word should be sample, but in case you want to edit it, you can do it yourself. There's a very common problem with names of products, locations, codes, and so on. Apply and you're done. It is telling me inconsistent number format. Two places, sure, that's an easy one. And finally, it had already corrected the spacing problem here, but now it is saying there is spelling variation there like we had in sample. So even if one column has mixed problems, it understands it. One click and it's done. One word of caution. It's a great feature, but there are times when you don't want to use it. Here is an example. It's suggesting that there are variations of Visio. The correction should have a comma or should not have a comma. It's a feedback form. People are choosing multiple items. It's a comma delimited list. So if I either keep a comma or I don't keep a comma, either way, it's a problem. The correct way to handle this particular column is use Power Query, split by delimiter using comma, but don't split it into columns. Go to Advanced, split it into rows. And when individual items come in a single column, then you can manage the spelling variations. Ideally, it should be a table, as I said, but it does work without a table. In terms of the data capacity, the documentation says 100 columns and 50,000 rows, so 5 million cells. That's the same limit, so to say, even for the analyze data feature. Now, what happens if you saw the suggestion and ignored it, or you're not seeing a suggestion at all? How do you get it back? It's there in the menu or ribbon, data, right next to text to columns, clean data, and you will get the pane again. There's one more great feature. Let's say you don't want to repair everything now because you're changing some data. So while I'm working on the data and editing it, if there is an additional mistake which is happening, it will understand that and it'll say, oh, there is a new suggestion available. Refresh this list. So this is live and dynamic. So if you found this useful, share it with your friends and colleagues. To continue your efficiency journey and learn more, subscribe to the channel, click on the bell icon, and give me ideas for more videos. So that's it. See you soon. Thank you.